give me some of that good old love.
Hey, what's up? No, it's me, Warren. And again with another video. So in this video, I'm gonna be talking about the five stages that your ex goes through while in a rebound. What's the steps? You know, what they go through. The first step, jumping right into it, is they find the victim. Not the call, you know, the rebound person. A victim or something like that, because a lot of times they don't know. But they find the new prospect, you know, the painkiller, you know, somebody to numb that pain. So they find that person first before they venture out into the to the rebound and stuff like that. A lot of times they rebound is probably somebody, you know, a friend of yours, a close relative to a family member. I mean, they, 9 times out of 10, you know this person. And a lot of times the rebound knows all about you. So before they venture out of your relationship, they find the prospect. You know, they find the victim. That's the first stage, finding the victim. You know, things of that nature. So moving on, the second one is they enter the honeymoon stage. Once they find who they're going to lead the relationship with, they go into the relationship with that person. And once they in the relationship with that person, they fascinated about that person and they just, you know, they want to forget all about their previous relationship. So they tell themselves they love them, that person, even though that's a lie. So they, you know, force themselves into the honeymoon stage. They would, you know, make up lies and say that they happy on this side over here. It's much better. They'll go out their way to show you that this person is better than you. But in reality, it's not. It's not. So those of you that's, you know, comparing yourself to the rebound, you're not, you know, there's no comparison. They can't compete with you. 9 times out of 10, they always find a downgrade of you. You know, rebound relationships are a downgrade from where they're coming from. So stop comparing yourself to the rebound. And the second stage is they force themselves into the honeymoon stage. A lot of times this honeymoon stage lasts for 6 months to a year. That's the average length of a honeymoon stage, but it's gonna be shorter because it's a rebound relationship. Rebounds are quick burnout relationships, so it's gonna be a lot shorter. Third stage is, you know, the breakdown. They start breaking down mentally. You know why? Because their mind is not in that relationship. Their body is. They're just a shell of a person going through the emotions. They on autopilot. Their mind is in that previous relationship where they left. Because the rebound, all they're getting is, you know, a shell of a person, the autopilot of the person. That's not the real them. That's why they're rushing stuff, because them emotions and all that stuff is just not there with that rebound. But for that rebound, you know, that's in that situation, you know, they don't know no better. They just, they thinking they having a real relationship. You know, they thinking that's the real thing. But to your ex, they know that's a rush relationship and it's a painkiller. Then sooner or later, reality start kicking in and they start realizing the grass is not greener on the other side. And they start breaking down, you know, and they start breaking down. Then after that, they blow up on it, you know, they rebound. They just start comparing. Well, you ain't like my previous relationship. You know, for example, like my ex, person I just left, they used to cook pancakes and, you know, they had the Mickey Mouse smile with the with the little chocolate chips and the blueberries mixed together. You can't do it like them. They start comparing their rebound to you. 'Cause keep in mind what I say. Their mind is there. I mean, their mind is not there. I'm sorry. Their mind is not there. It's with you. So therefore, they're going to be looking for, you know, similarities with the rebound, for the rebound to do characteristics of you. But keep in mind, they always pick a downgrade of you. So therefore, they're always going to look for the downgrade to do perform like you. No. So that's why they start exploding on that person. Like, look, man. Then their reality started to hit them. Like, man, I made a bad decision. You know, this is not like how I expected it to be. Then the last stage is the end of the rebound relationship. They just in it. All them emotions and all that stuff just boil up and it just explode and reality hit them like, I'm making a mistake. Let me at least try to call my ex back and see if I can get back with them and go from there. And that's why they start calling you and start coming back towards you, coming back around and all that stuff, and see if you will take them back, and you know, you'll forgive me. You know, let's work this thing out, you know, things of that nature. But I always tell people, if your ex leave you and jump into a rebound, let the rebound have them. Because the thing is, rebound relationship, that rebound person, they don't go away. They do not go away, you know, and they mind they hurt, so they want your ex back. So they're going to do whatever it takes to get them back. And once they venture out that relationship, it's like a part of them died. Just like the movie Pet Sematary, you know, and they died in your mind, mentally. The day that person left you is the day they died in your world. And you buried them in your mind, Pet Sematary. So the thing is, when they come back, they come back all messed up and jacked up and all that stuff. You don't know what you're getting, you know. Just don't accept that back. Please don't accept that back. The thing is, the most precious thing you have is time. Please don't let nobody waste your time, because you cannot get that back. Time is the most important thing you have. Work on yourself. Better yourself. 365 days of the year, working on yourself and bettering yourself to improve yourself and staying on your purpose. 365 days of the year. Don't wait till no new year. Don't wait till no new year to just start your purpose. Start your purpose now, today, when by the end of this video, you can start. Work on yourself. Pick the most important things in your life and cherish those things that don't help you and improve you and just hinder you. Get it out your life. You know, any kind of stress, any kind of things that, you know, is not benefiting you, get it out your life ASAP. And just work on yourself. Improve yourself. Write a list of things that's most important to you. And by doing anything, you will take the steps to getting better. Now, the thing is, if you need my help, the quickest way to get to me is through email. If you can't send an email, my number is in the description. Text me your problem. I do no text message coaching now. You know, we can do phone, Skype, WhatsApp, hell, smoke signal. If I figure that out, I would do that. But anyway, just to let you know I'm here, you know. Also, you can purchase my guide on Amazon if you want to. It's a small guide. You can purchase that, and it'll help you also with these type situations. But with that being said, you take care of yourself, love yourself, and put God first. Peace, man.
Some of that good old love. Girl, it's been so long since we've been together, yeah. And I can't explain the hurt I felt. since we've been apart. So come on.